Hello. Hello, hello, hello. It's been a little bit, and this is partially due to the fact that I forgot to switch off my thing, so I'm hearing myself. There we go. Now I'm not hearing myself. It's partially due to the fact that I had to fix my computer. Nothing crazy was happening with it, just the fans were very, very much knocking up against my laptop to the point where it was kind of sounding like it was grinding on itself. My fans have been problematic for some time on this computer, but it was just, it was getting to a point where I could no longer really ignore it. So I had to take it into a repair shop. Thankfully, the guy was able to get it repaired and send it back to me within like a day. So everything's fine. Computer's been working fine the whole time, so I wasn't really worried about the functionality. Just wanted to make sure the fans got repaired before anything else happened. I'm also coming right off the heels of my buddy Luke, aka Ingmar. He did a sort of interview type thing, interview slash podcast kind of stream with Evan Campbell of Rooster Teeth fame, which was pretty cool. So shout out to my buddy Luke and to Evan Campbell, who also knows Asura's Wrath, which maybe that's a game I should play on here at some point. Because oh my god, Asura's Wrath is probably is one of the most like objectively bad games that I love. Like, I unironically love that game. It is so much fun, but my god, it's bad. But getting off of that, we are going into what is currently playing, which, if you recognize the intro music here, or maybe you recognized it from the setting screen, this is Sea of Stars, and I guess you could also see the title of the video. But yeah, Sea of Stars. Been looking at this one for some time now, and I'm excited. Figure I get off Cassette Beasts for a little bit, go for a different pixelated 8-bit style, or not 8-bit, pixelated style RPG. But yeah, let's do it. And let me get the timer up. Oh, Sea of Stars has two main characters. Select the one who will lead the party. This can be changed later and does not affect the story. All right, well, first things first. Where the hell is my stream timer? I have so many things open right now for some reason. 30 minutes. Let's give it a start. Okay, and we'll get out of here so that my controller doesn't mess with the timer. Who do I want? Who am I choosing? Hold on. Oh, okay, there we go. Blade Dancer, born on the summer solstice, walks the path of the guardian god Solon. A monk, born on the winter solstice, walks the path of the guardian goddess Luana. I mean, if this doesn't affect the story, then I'll just start with Zale, see how much that actually affects things. Great Archives. Welcome to the Great Archives, adventurer. I suppose curiosity brought you here. An important trait, to be sure. I am the archivist, an immortal versed in the ways of alchemy. Oh! Perhaps you knew that already? After spending millennia cataloging the many events of countless timelines, I decided to return here to mull over everything I had seen. In my musings about the stories that fill these books and scrolls, I had a recent epiphany. It seems that in my haste I may have overlooked the very thing I was hoping to find. As such, there is one special story I wish to revisit, one deserving of a witness. A player, if you will. And should the mists of time allow a slight alteration, I believe the ray of hope that was once offered may yet bloom. So walk with me tonight, and we will explore a tale of high adventure, of magic and deceit, of friendship and wonder, but mostly a tale of heroism. One that I believe will offer valuable insight in the search for a resolution to the throes of the Fleshmancer. Now, I remain a bit lost amidst all these timelines and all their subtle variations, but I know just the one to make for a perfect starting point. Let us see what we find in there. Ah, yes! Our story begins in a world visited by the Fleshmancer generations prior, causing much turmoil and leaving a mark that is yet to be fully cleansed. Somewhere on Evermist Island, two brave children of the Solstice are on their way to meet with an immortal spirit. In order to become fully-fledged Solstice warriors, they will need to learn how to use magic without using magic. So I'm playing a game based on events that have already happened. But doesn't this involve time travel? All right, I need a voice for Zale. He's Tristan.
All right, we made it to the mountain trail.
So far, so good.
It's Tristan and Taya. Tristan and Taya have evolved to really main characters.
So the Elder Mist lives somewhere here, huh? Do you think it's just another test?
Could be, but it sure beats sitting at the academy.
And sewing.
Ha! Yeah, I'm sure glad that's over with. Apply yourselves, for the will you weave into it shall be your sole defense in times of greatest need.
While the lessons taught here may appear to be lost on you, something deep inside is compelled to learn.
That's cute.
Hey, the sun will be setting soon.
In another few hours, the sun will rise.
We should prepare to set up camp.
Let's split up and search for a good spot. Time for some scouting.
Whoa!
I'm coming through.
Okay, so this is, this feels very Chrono Trigger. Ooh, he's vulnerable. All right, let's go. Ouchies! All right. And he's dead.
Brugavis wasn't kidding. These feel easier to fight already. Let's see where this leads.
How to play. Movement. Use this to climb around, facing a climbable surface. Press A to snap on, then it says hoisting. Facing a ledge of 1, 2, or 3 units above you, press A to hoist up onto it. Jumping off ledges. We'll face it. Okay, press A to jump down. And swimming, use LS to enter and exit bodies. One or swim. Alright, cool. Combat. Timing hits. Your attacks and skills can be enhanced by pressing A at the right time to increase damage. Healing or score additional hits. Time your hits is not mandatory. Just think of it as a bonus to shoot for. Okay, that's good. All right, so timing, block at the right time. Skills, they cost MP. Okay, great. MP regeneration, regular attacks recover 3. Don't hesitate to use special skills even when you're not fighting a boss. For attacking with a full MP bar is a waste of regeneration. Okay, yeah, cool. Items carry limit 10. Are snacks cooked while camping or bought at shops? Okay, breaking locks. Enemies mounting special attacks will display a bar with locks. Deal damage of the relevant types to break these locks and weaken the enemy's action, or cancel altogether by break. Okay, so that's very Octopath. It's almost like Octopath Traveler 2 should have been nominated for Best RPG. Sorry, I'm gonna be bitter about that for a decent amount of time. Combos. Combos are powerful dual attacks that can be only just combo points. Okay, great. Vulnerabilities and resist. Some enemies are vulnerable to certain damage types, while others have resistances to others. Total of 6 damage types, though only 4 appear in the early game. Blunt, Sword, Moon, and Sun. Okay, cool. Summon characters. Have to take action. Your characters are on cooldown until your whole party is acted. While available, they connect in the order of your choice. Interesting. Survival? Relics. Amulet. The Amulet of Storytelling! The Relic menu offers ways to customize the experience. If you prefer later combat, it might be a good idea to activate the Amulet of Storytelling.
Oh.
Gotcha. Okay. If you prefer lighter combat. Yeah. Okay. So that's easy mode. Save points. Good. Shops. Most locations to sell equipment. Campsites always have a save point. Good to know. Most located villages and villages to sell equipment, cooking ingredients. Okay. Cool. Camping is free action. Cook items for later rest to fully heal. Good. Cooking. Cook. Okay. Let me tell my answer. Okay. Not combat. Healing. Blah, blah, blah. If you need to heal outside of combat, you can access your magic skills. Great. Fishing. I'll probably learn about fishing later. Okay. Cool. Resume. Whoa. Is he following me? I feel like he's following me. Yep. Okay, I have no skills. Okay, cool. I did time it. Ah, terrible.
Ouch, tough one, huh? Let's try this.
Ooh, sunball. Hold A for power. Gino Whirl. Ooh. Zale, found anything?
Just a dead end. How about you?
Nothing of note, but the way to the top is definitely through here. The sun is setting. Come over. I'll get a fire going.
I'll be right there. Can't wait for more tomato clubs.
Press A to unroll rope ladders.
Woo. Wee.
This music is extremely Chrono Trigger. Whoa. Would I have, like... was there any actual danger there, or... Uh-oh. All right. Let's sunball this guy. Hold A! Boom! Yeah! Cool. Woo! 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 Woo!
Ha! But it doesn't beat the face you made the first time you tried smashing a sunball!
Oh, I can still hear the headmaster gloating. As I said, whether by paying attention in class or by recklessly attempting to hit a projectile with your open palm, you will learn the fool's first rule of solar magic.
To be fair, you did learn!
Oh yeah, that one only took once. You ever miss those years? Before training, just being kids, always daydreaming and getting into trouble.
Hmm. and making mistakes.
I really appreciate the different profiles. I hope to see more. I won't say it's very Baten Kaidos. Certainly wasn't the first game to do something like that, but I always, always appreciate it. Is it Valerie or Valere? Valere?
Valere!
Sorry.
I'm sorry, Valerie. I didn't mean...
It's okay. I understand why he wouldn't want to join us after what happened. It's just... I wish he had said goodbye, you know? After 10 years of not seeing his face, just to know that he's all right.
And that we're still friends. Why did we have to get ahead of ourselves anyway? Oh, girl.
Oh, save point. I saw a save point.
10 years ago, in the village of Moon Cradle.
My weapon will be something that hits really hard!
And I'll pick a fast one!
We'll be unstoppable!
This is my voice for Garl now. This is my voice for Kid Garl.
Imagine all the wonders we'll find after we leave Evermist Island. I want to see the sleeper.
What's that?
You've never heard of the sleeper? Stories say it's a giant serpent, and it's been sleeping curled up around a mountain since even before there were traveling historians to record it.
No way!
Sure is, and it's super dangerous, too. But don't worry, it can't... it can wake up.
Why not?
Apparently, there's holes in the mountain, and the wind blows through them, and that plays a melody that keeps it asleep.
Whoa!
I want to see it, too! Oh, shit, the bell!
It's the bell. Erlina and Brugavis are back.
Quick, maybe we can catch them before they go to the academy.
Oh, okay. Okay, that's cool. Anything? No? I can only assume this is the academy. Oh, never mind. Hey there, younglings. Are you still playing in that little cave down below? I guess not. All right. Run along, children. Is this the academy? That looks like a cafeteria. I hope you're not getting into trouble again. Okay. Okay, so what terrible thing is going to happen? Why I can't traverse the... All right, fine, whatever. See if I care. I'm running in your garden. These crops are our main source of food. It's hard work, but I'm reminded every day when we all eat together that the effort is... Don't step in there! Oh.
Hey, wait!
Animated cutscenes? Oh my god, that's so cool. Alright, voice.
There you are.
Playing in your secret hideout again. Oh no, I got it. Playing in your secret hideout again.
We were training. I think I can use magic now.
Is that so? Let's see it then.
Whoa!
come closer, Zaya. Come.
I can't do it.
Fuck. Okay. Come closer, Zale. Oh, what the? Why are two of my timers going? Oh, that was super weird. I had two timers going at the same time. I didn't even realize it. Okay. Come closer, Zale. Open your palm and concentrate. Oh, right. Have to get back to the game itself. Okay.
What about you, Valerie? What have you been training to? Have you been training too?
Every day! I bet I'm stronger than you now!
I'm sure you are. Come here then.
Yeah!
Whoa, easy now. I can't report to the headmaster if you knock me out. Whoa! Whoa! That was awesome, Zale.
You did it.
Solstice warriors. If you are done with your babysitting duties, I would hear your report.
Right away, headmaster.
Can we go too?
Believe me, once you enter Zenith Academy, you'll wish you hadn't. Let's go, Brugaves.
Hey, the full moon is out.
Huh?
He's right.
Want to go to the Forbidden Cavern again?
We tried already. I can't open it.
Yeah, but last time we decided maybe the full moon could make the rune more sensitive.
I'm sure it will work. And Moraine will be so impressed, he'll take you two in for training right away. And then we'll finally be allowed to leave this island.
What if he gets mad and delays our training instead?
Nah, no way. Nothing possibly could go wrong with this.
Well, we can worry about that after I open it. I mean, if I open it.
All right, let's go.
Moon Cradle. So where, hold on, where do I go? Wait, where the heck? You were just here? Where did you go? All right, I guess that's a thing I can't use yet, probably. Remember, young ones, the celestial willow is a gift from the great eagle. Always treat it with respect. Where the f... Okay. So where's the Forbidden Cave? Is it just up ahead? I'd imagine it's up ahead. Oh, that's cute. Forbidden Cavern, yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Definitely gonna save. Seems like something terrible is going to happen.
We made it! Time to stop for a snack.
What? I'm not hungry.
Yeah, we just left a few minutes ago.
Look, it's not a real adventure if you don't eat a snack on the road. Plus, I made something special for the occasion. Here. A sandwich.
Wow, that's really good.
Yeah, no kidding.
Glad you like it. It's the jam. I used a bit of sap from the celestial willow.
You could get in trouble for that.
Only if you tell.
All right. How do I do this?
Maybe like Erlina showed me. Try opening your palm and concentrating.
You got this, Valerie.
I can't believe it. It worked. That's crazy.
I knew it!
It worked?
I did it.
I finally did it!
So, what now?
The headmaster must have heard the bell ring.
Do we just wait for him to show up?
Might as well enter. It can be our first adventure.
Yeah, and then the headmaster will know we're not afraid.
Oh, that always goes over well.
This is exciting. Let's go.
Oh, boy. Oh, man. The foreshadowing is strong here.
There's monsters over there. Let's hide.
I thought Evermist Island was safe. Guess that's only true for Moon Cradle.
We should go back. They look dangerous.
Yeah, good call.
Uh-oh.
Watch out! There's another one!
This is bad. We're surrounded.
Maybe try to use your powers.
We're not ready for this!
I don't know. Just try.
Okay, let me focus.
Watch out, it's preparing something.
Come on.
Zale, watch out!
No!
Gail!
Whoa! Oh, jeez.
My eye! It really hurts. I can't see.
There's no escape.
It's about to attack again.
So it was you. As resourceful as you are reckless, I see.
Headmaster, girl needs help!
It feels better. Like anyone born in Moon Cradle, a regular kid, what Garl needs is to not concern himself with the affairs of the Solstice Warriors.
I'm really sorry, Headmaster. It was all my idea.
Hey!
Be thankful that the only cost of this lesson was an eye, young lad. As for the two of you, if you are so eager to receive training, I shall oblige. Follow me.
I'm sure that's not traumatizing.
Make sure to treat the wound and soothe the poor kid. He's not the complaining type, but if the pain seems to return, please send for me.
Understood, Headmaster.
You will not see your friend for a very long time.
If you have any parting words, speak them now.
Can't he come and stay with us?
How long is very long? Like a week? Ah, the eagerness of youth. It takes years to properly train solstice warriors.
Years?
No way!
But your friends have much to learn. I would suggest you use that time to reflect upon what happened today. With any luck, it will help you forget any ideas of getting involved with a burden that is not yours to bear. Guys, don't forget about me.
Never!
We'll train really hard. Maybe it won't take so long.
Damn, really, just no time to, like, just be there for his friend, or for their friend. Like, just no time whatsoever as they go away for years. That just sucks.
Welcome to Zenith Academy. In this ancient place of knowledge, you will learn everything you need to know in order to become true solstice warriors.
We've been waiting for this for so long!
When do we start?
Tomorrow, though I believe a proper introduction is in order. Careful now. Welcome to the classroom in the sky.
Whoa, it's beautiful.
I'm feeling a weird resonance, like when I opened the Forbidden Cavern.
Good on you for noticing that. Getting closer to the stars helps new recruits get acquainted with their innate magic. It shows great promise that you were able to feel it before, and Zale too, from what Erlina told me.
Oh, it was just a small burst.
They have no idea how much potential they have. It is probably for the best. Now, in the many years you will spend at Zenith Academy, you will learn about the duties incumbent upon solstice warriors, of the magic you are destined to wield, and the evils it is meant to cleanse.
We'll learn how to fight too, right?
Naturally, you will spend your days training and studying, but most importantly, sewing.
Sewing?
That sounds boring!
Oh, I can assure you that it is. A mandatory task, nonetheless. All who would join our order begin by weaving their will into an enchanted piece of fabric, the staple of the solstice warrior. It is their most prized possession, guaranteeing light in the darkest places, and a measure of protection against the minions of the Fleshmancer. But first, you must learn of your duties, train until you cannot feel your limbs, and then train some more. Once both your body and mind are ripe with potential, you will create a magic piece of fabric worthy of the very stars. You will then be sent out beyond the Forbidden Cavern to meet with the Elder Mist, for it alone may officially grant the title of Solstice Warrior.
Sewing.
I understand it is not what you were hoping for, but it is what is required of you for the time being.
Years of sewing!
That will be all for today. You will be spending a lot of time in these halls, so you should make yourselves at home. To your left is the training room. You are to go there first thing in the morning. Just above is the way to my chambers. It is off limits, of course. And to your right are the dormitories. Just make sure you pick a bed aligned with your innate magic. Feel free to look around, then go to sleep when you are ready. Good night.
All right, then. Okay, with that, I'll resume studying, and I'll be back in half an hour. Enjoy the licensed music that'll probably get this video copyright struck in a bunch of locations. I guess technically it's not licensed. I didn't license it, but yeah. This little talks is fine.
Telling you to close your eyes. And some days I can't even dress myself. It's killing me to see this way. Cause though the truth may bury this, ship will carry our bodies safe to the shore. You're gone, gone, gone away. I watched you disappear. All that's left is a ghost of you. Now we're torn, torn, torn apart. There's nothing we can do. Just let me go, we'll meet again soon. Now wait, wait, wait for me. Please hang around. I'll see you. Though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our bodies safe to shore.
Gonna get through the section and then I'll be back on. Shouldn't be too long. Oh, sorry, Luke. Yeah, the issue I could no longer ignore was the fan in my laptop. It was, yeah, it was getting like kind of rumbly at first, and then And then like a couple days ago, it became like grindy. So it was really bad. But in any case, let's set the timer for 30. I should probably just end the stream here. I've made it through a decent amount tonight of the material, so I think I'm actually feeling pretty okay with where I'm at. So we will end the stream after after this session. All right, so as I recall, I'm looking around, just getting to know the place. The left is the training, I believe. I believe the dude said. Oh, there you are. Moraine finally decided that you were ready. And then this is the headmaster's headquarters, off limits. Perfect. Who's this guy?
I remember when Erlina and Brugaves were your age. They wouldn't stop running. Ugh, I feel old now.
Ooh. Ah, the dormitories. Damn, these are nice. Oh, save point. It's funny, that animation kind of reminds me of Ikenfell, but, I mean, in Ikenfell, the save points were cats. Yeah, this... I'm getting some Ikenfell vibes here.
I think this bed is for me. Let's find yours.
Oh, because she's the moon and he's the sun. Wait, what? Oh, okay. Oh, okay. I thought the one lit in the sun would be, yeah, okay.
Go to sleep?
Yeah. Cool.
The next morning, in the training room.
Well, good morning, fellas.
Brugaves!
So you'll be our trainer? I wish. Erlina and I are leaving tomorrow, but the headmaster was kind enough to let us make your first day special. Are you ready for training?
You bet!
That's what I like to hear. I reckon these should be well suited for the two of you.
Whoa, training sword. Let's go. Training staff.
All right, let's get to work. You got this, Valerie. Don't give up now.
Never!
You gotta go fast. Come on, Zao. Keep up. Well, I can do this.
Damn. There's a lot of pixelated training montages.
Well, 99, 100. That's it for today. You did great.
Whew.
That was a lot.
Feel free to take a break. Erlina will see you on the terrace whenever you're ready.
More running.
Oh, that leads nowhere. Okay. Oh, there you are. Ready to learn magic? It should feel as if something was scratching an itch far away from you. You must focus on the sensation and compel it to come closer.
I think it's working!
Hey, you startled me. I almost had it.
Now mine's gone too.
It's okay. Just breathe slowly. Try to release only when you feel its current passing in front of you. If your timing is true, it will manifest on three. One, two, three.
I think I felt it.
It tickles.
Right there. You just did the hardest part. I'm sure your training will go well, but one more thing. No matter what the headmaster teaches you, remember that this is your life, and...
Erlina! Since you are done onboarding our new recruits in the ways of magic, I would provide the briefing for your next assignment. As for the two of you, it is about time you tried that sewing kit. Move along now.
And making a magic piece of fabric worthy of the very stars sure is a tall order.
Yeah, I have no idea what shape to even make.
At least the headmaster said we wouldn't get it right the first time. Well, I'm bored.
What are you doing?
I'll just walk around a bit. Well, I'm bored. This school sucks. I want out.
Something here?
Sewing basics. Nope. I'm bored.
You keep saying that, but the Fleshmancer left our realm for good when the Dweller of Strife was destroyed. So why can't they have a normal life? And you know the three of us can take on... The one on Wraith Island. We don't need them.
Prudence, Erlina. There is no telling what threats we may face in the future. Zael and Valerie were brought to Mooncradle by the Great Eagle. It is not the place of the headmaster to question such things, and neither is it yours.
So how much is enough? What about Muyara? What about the twins?
Brugaves!
Oh. Ho, ho, ho.
Do not judge a sacrifice you cannot begin to comprehend. This conversation is over. They will study here while you carry on with your investigation. On the first eclipse after their training is complete, they will join us for the cleansing. Learn as much as you can until then.
But...
Let's just go, Brugaves.
And so they trained, and they sewed for days, and then for months. Faster now! Focus, and then release.
And the longer a dweller is left to its devices, the stronger it gets. This makes patrol duty essential. Let one grow for too long, and you have a world eater on your hands. Against such a foe, even a legion of Solstice warriors would be helpless. Since delaying only increases the chances of a world eater, cleansings always target the strongest dweller known to us.
Headmaster, if dwellers are immune to our magic, how can we fight them?
Ah, that is why cleansings are always performed during a total eclipse. In these moments only, the dwellers' weaknesses are exposed.
How many dwellers are left?
Just the one, known as the Dweller of Woe. But we cannot know for sure. The Fleshmancer just may have planted other seeds of evil before leaving our world. Thus we must always remain vigilant.
Headmaster?
Yes, Sale.
What happened with the Dweller of Strife? And who's Moyara?
Uh-oh.
That will be all for today.
A few weeks later, a sound in the night.
Zale, wake up!
Valerie, what is it?
I think I heard a voice coming from the entrance.
What time is it?
Who cares? Let's go check it out.
All right.
May as well save, right?
A sound in the night.
Hey, look.
Oh, smells good.
There's a note.
Dear Zale and Valerie, if you're reading this, it probably means I got caught. I'm writing this as a fail-safe, but I hope to see you in person. I made cookies filled with the celestial willow jam you liked.
Aww.
Keep reading.
I'm doing everything I can to be ready to leave when you graduate. In the meantime, I hope your training is going well. Oops, now the platform is almost up and I can see Moraine is there waiting for me. He looks very angry. I will try to drop the jar without him noticing. I guess that means I won't be able to try a visit again. But I'm thinking of you every day and I can't wait. I hope you like the cookies. Your friend until the end of time, Garl.
Garl's the best.
Let's go up on the disc to eat the cookies.
Sweet.
These cookies are amazing! I can't believe Garl was just there.
I miss him so much.
He seems well, at least, after what happened in the Forbidden Cavern.
Knowing him, I bet he smiled it away the next day.
Haha, you're probably right.
We can't let something like this happen ever again.
At this rate, it feels like we'll never sow something good enough for the Elder Mist.
It will happen! We just have to keep on training hard.
Okay, you need to switch up the exercise that you do. Like, you know, Zale is always doing push-ups and Valerie is always doing sit-ups. Like, can we switch them so that they can each get like a different workout?
And so they trained and they sewed for years. And then they trained, and they sewed some more.
No, you're not supposed to do the same exercise.
Until one day.
Uh-oh.
Zale! That's the one!
I can feel it too. Hold on. All right. I think I got it too. Let's go see the headmaster.
Is he dead? I feel like he's dead. Heroes in the making.
Headmaster, we think we're ready.
Why, yes. The tingling of magic in the air has been building up for a few weeks now. Congratulations. Moving forward, there will be no more sewing.
I can deal with that.
It will soon be time for you to leave on your journey to meet the Elder Mist. But before we get to that, Zenith Academy has one more challenge for you. Oh, our visitors just arrived. Perfect timing.
Hey.
Hey, you've both grown pretty strong. Hey, it's good to see you.
Erlina and Brugaves are here to help you review the basics of combat. Check in with them, then it will be time for your final test.
Want to review combat basics?
Yeah, sure.
Let's get started. Just attack me now in any order.
All right, cool.
Party members can use their turn in the order of your choice, but they can only act once per round. When all of your party members are on cooldown, the round resets and they'll all become available again.
Good. Focus is paramount whenever you perform attacks and skills. With proper timing, you can increase the damage that you deal, and sometimes even score additional hits. Let's see it.
Press A as the hit connects. Okay, cool.
Good. Let's see that one more time. That was too soon. Stay focused and press as the hit connects. Ouch! Yeah, that's the gist of it. Most of your attacks and spells can be made more potent with proper timing. Some also keep going with more hits until you miss. And remember to think of timed hits as a welcome addition when you pull it off, rather than something you're supposed to do perfectly all the time. Mr. Perfectionist Gamer, I see you over there. It's okay to miss. So don't worry about it too much. Just keep on trying and your sense for it will develop over time. Okay, now for timing your blocks. Let's get the little guy in here. To be efficient in battle, you must pay attention to anything that starts moving. With proper timing, you can reduce the damage of any incoming attack or spell by blocking. Get ready!
Alright, it's a good thing I played Mario RPG somewhat recently.
Press A as the hit connects to reduce damage.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
That was too soon. Stay focused and press as the hit connects.
There we go.
Good, let's see that one more time.
Nope, too much. Too soon. Okay. There we go.
That's how you do it. Remember to always stay alert. Some patterns will be harder to read than others, sometimes even requiring multiple blocks. But don't be too hard on yourself. No one is expected to block everything all the time. It's not about getting it perfectly all the time, but rather building a growing sense for it. Just think of a timed block as a welcome bonus whenever you happen to pull it off. The key is remembering to read your enemies and to keep trying. Oh, one more thing. When a party member gets knocked down in battle, you'll need to switch to a more defensive mode.
KO'd allies will get back up on their own at 50% HP once all the KO stars are gone. One KO star is removed at the end of each round. The more you fall during the same battle, the more KO stars there are. So be careful. If all party members go down, it's game over. Fight and survive until Valerie returns.
That's cool.
And there you have it. Good work today. I'm sure the exam will be a breeze.
That's really cool, actually.
Ready to go through the basics of magic? When enemies prepare spells, you must do everything you can to prevent them. If you follow your senses, you can try dealing damage of the types that will break their concentration. Simpler spells will only demand normal attacks. Valeray can do blunt damage, and Zale has slicing. Let's see you break this one. Just like that. Now some spells will also demand magic damage to break. You can control your projectiles now, so let's give it a shot. Zale for sun and Valeray for moon.
Moonerang! Oh, that's cool.
Well done. Now you can sense your MP is a bit low, right? To keep up the pace in battle, you must remember to regenerate MP. Let's build it back up a bit. Hit me with a normal attack now. Did you feel that? You just got some MP back by attacking. In battle, awareness leads to victory. You must pace your spells with the normal attacks to avoid ending up in a dire situation with no MP available to get out of it. Oh, clicked out of the game. And on the flip side, you should not hesitate to use spells when MP abounds, for a regular attack on a full bar is a waste of regeneration. The key is to experiment, keep on varying your actions, and find the rhythm appropriate for each battle. One last thing. All battle actions, lock breaking especially, build your combo energy. When you have enough, you can spend combo points to perform powerful actions. Combos cost no MP and are lost after battle, so you should never hesitate to use them. Maureen told me you came up with your first combo attack. Show it to me.
Solstice Strike.
Yeah, you're strong, all right. Keep an eye out in your adventures. You're bound to come across scrolls that will teach you more combos. Good luck with the exam. I'm sure you'll do great. Maureen, we'll see you to the final test. I'm sure you'll do great.
Are you ready for the final test, then? Then let us begin. The big day has finally come. Over the years, Zenith Academy has tested you in many ways. It will now test you one last time. Have you prepared your vows?
Yes, Headmaster.
Oh, God.
Then speak them now.
You go first, Zale.
Okay. So that I may use my agility to cleanse this world and protect my companions, I will enter the world as a blade dancer. I chose the curved blade as it will not hinder my speed or reflexes.
Welcome, blade dancer.
Come on, Valeray. I did it. Now it's your turn.
Ahem. So that I may use my strength to inspire hope and eradicate evil, I will become a battle monk. I chose the staff, for it won't break no matter how hard I strike.
Welcome, battle monk. Today, you must demonstrate mastery of everything Zenith Academy has taught you. Your final challenge awaits below.
Oh boy, that voice is kind of hard to keep up.
Please step aside. Oh, before I forget, here's a little something to keep your health full.
Tomato Club, let's go!
Now, with faith in your abilities and purpose in your actions, take the leap and return as the new recruits of our order.
I'm ready, Zale!
Let's just go for it.
Whee! Boop! Okay. Ah, very cool. Okay.
Wee, woo, woo, woo!
Twisha! Found an ornate stone, okay? Wait, what? Okay, so these... Oh. Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. I mean, may as well. Sunball! Ooh, it did damage to both of them. Ah, son of a bitch. I keep forgetting, they attack so slowly. Alright, yeah, screw it, skills. Crescent arc, smashes enemies in an arc. Lunar magic protects up to multiple targets. Okay, cool. I'm just gonna do crescent arc. See what that's all about. Okay, it's just a slower attack. 16 experience points, let's go. Oh, okay, wait. Anything back here? No. Anything back here? No, didn't think so. All right, climb up. Whee! All right, nothing, nothing. Hup, 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 hup. Okay, getting a stone. Yep, walking the tightrope, and boom. Okay, let's go. Oh. Yeah. Ah. Okay. There we go. Damn it. Let's go. Okay. All right. Blocked. And hup. Okay, skills. You know what? No, I'm gonna save the MP because I feel a combo coming on. Yeah, combo. Yeah. Walk across the tight. Rope, walk across the tight rope, walk across the tight rope, tight rope, walk across the tight rope, walk across the tight rope, do-do-loop. Going up the platform, going up the platform to my final exam while the others...
They haven't even been to the other side of the Forbidden Cavern yet. How could they understand?
So you don't think we should at least try and explain?
You've seen how strong they are. Word will be a walk in the park.
Hmm. Let's see them off then.
Exam mode engaged. Brace yourselves. I have to pee.
Shuffle weakness physical. Okay. Oh. No shot. This is where I actually end it. I don't think I can end it. Yeah, it kind of sucks, actually. I'm so used to playing the Switch and being able to just stop at any point. Yeah, screw him. Let's do it. Oh, that did nothing. Okay. Okay. All right. Did I block that? I feel like I blocked it. Okay, physical weakness. Boom! Damn it, I'm missing. It's okay, though. It's okay, though. Timing it right is a bonus. It's not required. His attack is... Okay. His weakness is moon. Sure. Ah! I missed it. Oh. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. This is a really good tutorial, actually. His weakness is still moon, so I'm not gonna. You know, actually, let's do a little healing light on Valerie. There we go. Okay, physical weakness. That's fine. Let's combo it up. Solstice Strike. Yeah. Let's go. That's cool. Let's see. I mean, getting that extra 3 physical defense seems right. If this is Mario RPG logic, it seems like the max bonus will rotate. 8 hit points? I mean, that's got right? That's got to be the thing to go with, right? I can't even choose regular defense, so... 3 magic. Oh, actually, the magic defense might be relevant. All right, whatever. Yeah, we'll go with magic defense.
Congratulations, you have been trained well. Return now to your headmaster.
Woo!
Congratulations, Zale and Valerie. You have learned everything Zenith Academy had to teach you.
Ha! We did it!
In record time, too. You must now learn of our ultimate power, the ability to use magic without using magic.
Huh?
But that knowledge is for the Elder Mist to impart. Come, the villagers have gathered to celebrate your departure. It is on special days such as this one that the citizens of Mooncradle are reminded of the importance of their duties.
Where's Garl?
I don't see him.
Many years ago, Zael and Valerie were delivered to us by the Great Eagle.
Deliveries on two solstices in a row to boot! A very rare occurrence.
Oh, I remember. Gran was so happy to get to meet two more before she passed.
I miss Gran.
All of you have come together to nurture and protect them, just like your ancestors have done for so many children of the solstice before. Zael and Valerie, step forward so that the good people of Mooncradle might gaze upon those who will soon join the ranks of the solstice warriors.
This parading is ridiculous.
Now let the villagers have their fun. It's all they get.
So you're okay with this now?
You know I'm not.
Now, cheer with me as we send these young heroes out across the Forbidden Cavern to meet the Elder Mist.
Hooray! Yay! To the gate! Yeah, yeah! Let's go! Yeah! What do we do? I want to see Garl before leaving!
I guess we have to play along for now.
Fingers crossed that we can come back after meeting this Elder Mist.
Fingers and toes.
Okay.
Zael, Valerie, you must undertake this journey on your own now.
We will not fail, Headmaster!
Go now, through the Forbidden Cavern, and atop the mountain trail, to seek audience with the Elder Mist. Learn how to use magic without using magic, and you shall then enter the world as true solstice warriors.
May Luana's might protect you! May Solon's light guide you!
Here, this should keep you fed for a little bit.
Tomato Club!
And if your adventure feels a little tough, you could take a look at these.
The Amulet of Storytelling. Sequent Flare?
You just received your first two relics. Find them in the relics section of the game menu, accessible with Y, to adjust your experience. Whether you prefer a lighter challenge or are looking to push yourself to the max, relics offer a range of options. There's bound to be more to find. Remember to keep an eye out for merchants. Selling any valuables you find will keep you well-fed and well-equipped. Now, wherever your adventures take you, you must remember your first assignment. After the Elder Mist sends you out into the world, you must secure passage to Wraith Island in time for the next eclipse. And do keep on training, for a dire cleansing awaits us.
I still can't believe he wants them fighting a dweller already.
That's Moraine for you. We weren't much older the first time.
Yeah, but...
we'll find a way.
Safe journeys, and may you cleanse this world.
May you cleanse this world!
Can I... Can I save? Right? The Forbidden Cavern has a save point, right? Yeah, there it is. Cool. Alright, cool. Okay, with that, It is about time that I end the stream, so thank you very much and good night, everyone. How the hell do I stop? There we go.